Tomato, tomato, potato, potato, squalene, squalane. What is the difference between the two? So today we're going to be talking about those two ingredients in skincare and how it may affect your skin. Stay tuned. So both of those are lipids and they are contained in human sebum. And actually in human sebum, it can contain up to 13% of squalene. So it's also found in fish liver oil, such as shark liver, but it's also found in plants and non-animal species, such as rice bran, palm oil, olive oil. So when you see it saying that it is plant-derived or non-animal-based, that's usually where it comes from. Squalane is actually a hydrocarbon, and it actually consists of 6 non-conjugated double bonds, which basically means that it is unstable and it is prone to oxidation. Squalene is actually highly oxidative when exposed to pollutants such as ozone and cigarette smoke, and sensitive to oxygen-free radicals created in the skin, such as when... UVA and UVB radiation. So although squalene is a pretty popular facial choice for people, I don't recommend squalene to oily skin and breakout prone skin types. And the reason why is because when squalene oxidizes, it can turn to peroxide, which then instigates inflammation, which it can increase breakouts, hyperpigmentation, formation of wrinkles, and rough skin. So how the sebaceous glands can respond to the peroxidation of squalene is it increases overproduction of oil and the peroxidation of the squalene and glycerides. Now squalane, L-A-N-E, is a derivative of squalene, L-E-N-E. It's basically a hydrogenation of the squalene. It's more stable and it's best used in areas where you have dry, rough patches of skin, such as your elbows, your knees, and the bottom of your feet. So obviously when used as a skincare ingredient, it serves as an emollient and a moisturizer, and some people even use it on their scalp. So squalane has some antibacterial properties and can help the skin barrier remain intact, which is great for people who have dry skin type. So if you haven't caught that video on skin condition versus skin type,
that was really loud.
Oh, let's try it again. You're killing me! So if you haven't caught that video on skin condition versus skin type in helping you choose the right product for you, you might want to catch that one. And if you're liking this video, please give us a thumbs up to let us know that you're liking this video, you like the information. If you haven't subscribed, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button and of course that notification bell. So stay tuned for next week's video when we do a product review on the Ordinary's 100% plant-derived squalanes facial oil. Because remember, makeup is an art and skincare is a science. Thanks for watching.